Hey guys, Andrew Esquivel here, back with part two of how we implement a reverse osmosis filtration system for your fish tanks. So once again, this is a very basic, simplistic explanation of how to implement this and use it. We're not going to go into extreme detail here, but this should help those of you who are beginners understand the core concepts of how we work with these things. So, hopefully you've watched part one of this video series. If you haven't, I would suggest you do so because it has some key information that if you don't know, you might be a little confused about what we're about to talk about. But if you have watched it, congratulations, we are now going to continue on from there. So, as we talked about in the first video, we need some place to store the reverse osmosis water. Because this is how fast we produce RO water. It's pretty slow. That's not really fast enough to fill a fish tank now, is it? Well, it takes a long time. My system produces 50 gallons per day. This is a 32-gallon drum that we're using to store the water in. And it's been going overnight for about 12 hours, and you can see we haven't even filled it up all the way. But we can still at least do one of the fish tanks to get the TDS and GH closer to what we want it to be. So what we have right down there is a pond water pump. That pond water pump has a few adapters to connect it to a standard garden hose. Now that pond water pump is connected and it is running. Plugged up where all that tech spaghetti is. And we have it going into this hose. So if we take the end of this hose right here, which I have a special little adapter here that disperses the outpour of water so it's more gentle. We undo the valve here. Woohoo! We got water! So, all we really need to do at this point is not make a mess, for one. There's always a little residual water left over because of the size of the head right here. But we take this, and this is my shrimp tank, and I'm just going to let it gently flow out. Place it like so. And voila! We have reverse osmosis water coming into the fish tank. Now, really quickly, in the first video we talked about the necessity to remineralize reverse osmosis water, especially if it's reverse osmosis deionized water, because the system will strip most, if not all, of the hardness from the water, making it pretty pure. But creatures don't want pure water. They need some sort of trace elements to survive. This is important. Now, I have not added any minerals to this RO water yet. Why? Because I am currently just using the water in this tank, which was already hard, at around 22 degrees of hardness, 800 parts per million of TDS, which some people are going to say, whoa, that's really, really high. And yeah, it is. Granted, they have been doing well in this tank for quite some time now. It's the same with these shrimp. They've been breeding pretty well. It's the same with these Mexican dwarf crayfish. Same with my pumpkin shrimp. Same with peaches and, well, my plecos, my vampire shrimp, and my crayfish, and my wild tanks. You gotta understand, all these fish and invertebrates have been doing just fine with those water parameters. One thing I want to reiterate right here is don't chase the pH. Fish and other aquatic creatures tend to do really well by having stable conditions rather than fluctuating conditions that you're trying to get perfect. So keep that in mind.
Now, even though my parameters are far different than what is the recommended parameters for this species, this is a testament to how hardy the Neocaridinia davidii species of shrimp is. So I just want to explain that really quick. I'm going to go over these shrimps in general in a video sometime soon and explain, you know, just how awesome these shrimp are and why they're considered hardy. But we are just about full now, so I'm going to cut off the valve here. And just like that, we have topped off our tank with RO water, and we are stepping down, in this case, the GH, the KH a little bit, and the TDS, which I am trying to get the perfect parameters out of this as an experiment to see what the shrimps ultimately prefer. But that being said, my special case aside, this is really all it is. Instead of having a hose directly go into the tank to fill it up like I've been doing for years, and like I said, that kind of method has been working for me. Instead now, it's just a simple intermediary step. Instead of water goes directly to tank, it's water goes to bucket, and bucket water goes to tank. Really, not all that hard. And yeah, okay, there's going to be a mess of hoses. But ultimately, you know, just doing some tidying up and organization, yeah, it's not going to be hard. Now, the great thing about it is, once again, is if the water is pure to begin with, you can then convert it to however you want, whatever custom parameters you need from the get-go, because technically it is easier to start with perfect water, perfect in the sense meaning purified as pure can be, and then customizing it to your needs, rather than having, well, just random water and hoping the inhabitants are okay with it. Now, there's different reasons and different arguments for either method, but this is one method that's new to me that I'm going to try out. But hopefully, this explanation makes you feel more comfortable with the idea of an RO system, showing you that it's not hard, it's actually quite simple, and can be implemented just as easily across a bunch of different tanks all at once, instead of just one tank at a time. So even a 50-gallon per day reverse osmosis filtration system can work for all of these tanks, because remember, every week you're only replacing 20% of the water, not the entire water amount of the tank. So, even a 55-gallon drum, or in this case, a 33 or 32-gallon drum, should be sufficient for the most part. So, that being said, hopefully this guide was helpful to you as part two. Part three, we'll go over some more intricate details. And, you know, we'll just have to wait for that to come out whenever I can get around to doing that. But, hey, if you liked it, please give me a thumbs up. Don't forget to comment, rate, subscribe, show your friends, check out my other videos. I got plenty of them. And as always, I'll see you next time. Stay fishy.